Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Hello students, today we are going to continue with chapter 5, Forms of Business Organization 1. In my last lecture, I explained you about sole proprietorship. Now today we are going to study another form of business organization, that is HUF, Hindu Undivided Family. Okay, now what is this Hindu Undivided Family? Students, in this Hindu Undivided Family, a person can get membership by his birth only. You can say one type of a family business. Okay, this business can be acquired by inheritance. Okay, if a father gives his family business to his son, so all the members of the family are the members of this HUF. But the senior most person of the family, okay, known as Karta, okay, he is the main person of this HUF. Characteristics of this HUF, first, existence by law. Okay, this HUF has got the existence by law, it is accepted by law. Second, management. The management of this HUF lies within the hands of a Karta. Senior most person jo family ka hota hai na, is known as a Karta, and he is only the he is only going to manage, his decisions are the final. Independent field of operation. Okay, the senior most person of the family known as Karta, as I told you earlier that he is going to manage everything. So he is free to take all the decision. All the other family members, they can help him, but they cannot go against him. Membership. Okay, one can acquire the membership in this HUF by birth. Second, financial control. All the financial control rests with the Karta, the senior most person of the family. Liability. See, liability of Karta in this is unlimited. I already explained you what you mean by unlimited liability. Okay, so liability of Karta is unlimited, while liability of rest of the members is up to their share only. Jitna unka share hoga, wahi tak unki liability hogi, otherwise not. Lifespan. Lifespan of such type of HUF is also limited. If the senior most person of a family dies, the other members, the other person who is next senior most, he can continue the business. Difficulty in raising funds. Okay, as it is a family business, the family members have only to arrange for the capital, especially the senior most person, he has to arrange the capital. So here also it many times it become difficult in raising funds. Insolvency. Okay, if the senior most person of the HUF becomes insolvent, the firm is considered to be insolvent. Next form of business is partnership. Okay, you must be heard, you must have seen or heard about partnership. Okay, so according to Indian Partnership Act 1932, partnership is a relation between such person who have agreed to share profit of a business which is run by all or by one person on behalf of others. Okay, isme kya hota hai, if there are two persons or more than two persons, they join hand for some business. Wo business ke liye haath mila rahe and agree to share all profit or loss in the business. Jo bhi profit ya loss hoga, wo agree kar rahe hain share karne ke liye, theek hai? Aur wo saath mein manage kar rahe hain business. Or either one person can manage the business on the behalf of all. This type of firm is known as a partnership firm. Now, characteristics of this partnership firm. First, relation by agreement. Okay, in this partnership firm, agreement is necessary. It may be written or oral. Written bhi ho sakta hai, oral bhi ho sakta hai, but agreement is must. Second, establishment procedure. Establishment procedure is quite easier. There are no much legal procedures or what. It can be easily established. Registration. Registration is not compulsory, but it is advisable. Compulsory नहीं होता है कि partnership हम register हो, लेकिन better है कि registration better is it is to register the firm. Number of partners, okay, number of partners minimum 2, okay, maximum 50 are required in partnership firm. Purpose, okay, purpose, what purpose means, if the टू और थ्री persons दे आर हैविंग पार्टनरशिप फॉर एनी सोशल पर्पस. ओके, कोई सोशल सर्विस कर रहे हैं या कोई ऐसा काम कर रहे हैं जिसमें कोई प्रॉफिट नहीं है, उसके लिए वो अगर हाथ मिला रहे हैं तो डैट इज नॉट अ पार्टनरशिप. एंड फॉर बींग अ पार्टनरशिप इट इज नेसेसरी दैट देयर मेन पर्पस इज प्रॉफिट. कैपिटल, कैपिटल इज ब्रॉट बाय ऑल द पार्टनर्स एज पर द एग्रीमेंट. मैनेजमेंट, मैनेजमेंट राइज रेस्ट विद द ऑल द पार्टनर्स, दे हैव ऑल एज पर द अग्रीमेंट दे हैव टू मैनेज द फर्म. अनलिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी, एज पर एज लाइक सोल प्रोपरेटरशिप यर ऑल्सो ऑल द पार्टनर्स दे हैव अनलिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी. सबकी लाइबिलिटी अनलिमिटेड होती है. मीन्स इफ एनी ऑफ द पार्टनर्स इज नॉट एबल टू पे द बिजनेस ड्यूज देन ऑल एनी पार्टनर्स दे हैव टू सेल द पर्सनल प्रॉपर्टी एंड क्लियर देयर ड्यूज. ट्रांसफर ऑफ ओनरशिप, ट्रांसफर ऑफ ओनरशिप इज नॉट पॉसिबल. मीन्स वन पार्टनर कैन नॉट ट्रांसफर हिज शेयर टू एनीबडी एल्स विदाउट द कंसर्न ऑफ अदर पार्टनर्स. हाँ यस, इफ अदर पार्टनर्स गिव द कंसर्न वो रेडी है देन ही कैन गो फॉर डेट. लीगल स्टेटस, पार्टनरशिप हैज ऑल्सो गॉट द लीगल स्टेटस. लाइफ स्पान ऑफ द फर्म, लाइफ स्पान ऑफ द फर्म इज लिमिटेड. शॉर्ट, इफ डेथ ऑफ एनी पार्टनर अकर्स और एनी पार्टनर बिकम इनसॉल्वेंट देन मेनी टाइम्स पार्टनरशिप कम्स टू एन एंड. इफ अदर पार्टनर्स ऑन द म्यूचुअल एग्रीमेंट एग्री टू कंटिन्यू देन इट्स ओके, अदरवाइज इट्स कम टू एन एंड. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट एडवांटेजेस ऑफ पार्टनरशिप फर्म. ओके, फर्स्ट इज इजी एंड लेस एक्सपेंसिव प्रोसेस ऑफ एस्टेब्लिशमेंट. ओके, द प्रोसेस ऑफ दिस पार्टनरशिप फर्म इज क्वाइट इजी एंड लेस एक्सपेंसिव. ओके, इट हैज नो मोर लीगल रिस्ट्रिक्शन, नो मोर प्रोसीजर और स्पेशल परमिशंस आर रिक्वायर्ड, सो इट कैन बी इजीली एस्टेब्लिश लाइक सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप. इफिशियंट मैनेजमेंट, ओके, मैनेजमेंट कैन बी डन इफिशियंटली बिकॉज डिफरेंट पार्टनर्स आर देयर, ऑल हैव देयर डिफरेंट स्किल्स intelligence. So the use of the different skill, intelligent knowledge can be made and management can be made efficient. Increase in goodwill, or you can say credit worthiness. See, if partner's liability is unlimited, okay, so the credit worthiness of the firm increases. The suppliers, they know that they are supplying the material or raw materials whatsoever, all the partner's liability is unlimited, so one or other partner will pay them. So the credit worthiness of such type of a firm increases. More capital, as there are more partners, like in sole proprietorship only one person is there, but here more partners are there, so more capital can be brought. Advantage of division of labor, division of labor means if the work among all the partners is allotted, yani kisi ko purchase department de diya, kisi ko marketing, kisi ko to handle the customers or डिपार्टमेंट वर्कर्स, इफ दे आर एक्सपर्ट इन सो, वो जो जिस फील्ड में एक्सपर्ट हो उनको अगर वो वर्क अलॉट कर दिया, सो वी कैन हैव द एडवांटेज ऑफ डिविजन ऑफ लेबर. ओके, प्रॉपर डिसीशंस कंपेयर टू सोल प्रोपरेटरशिप, ये प्रॉपर डिसीशंस कैन बी टेकन बिकॉज एनी डिसीशन इज टेकन आफ्टर हैविंग डिस्कशन इन द पार्टनर्स. फर्स्ट डिस्कशन होता है, वो सब आपस में डिस्कस करते हैं एंड देन ओनली इट इज अप्रूव्ड, सो प्रॉपर डिसीशंस कैन बी taken. These all are the advantages of partnership. Again, we are going to continue with the advantages. Flexibility, like sole proprietorship, partnership is also quite flexible. Okay, easily the changes can be made in the firm. Jo bhi changes karne ho, with the mutual concern, all the partners can make the changes. Protection of interest of minority. Okay, if any decision is to be taken, and if any of the partner is not ready for that decision, so that cannot be taken. And if others they are does not agree with him, then he can leave the partnership. He can put the end to his partnership. Direct relation with the customers, like sole proprietorship, in partnership also partners can maintain direct relation with customers. Next is decentralization of economic power. Economic power does not rest with one person. Okay, all partners are there, they have equal power, so it is not one person in the hand of one person. Next, less burden of income tax. Here also whatever profit of the firm is there, it is divided among the partners. Partners may divide ho jata hai, so the burden of income tax is less. So here we complete with the advantages. Now limitations, or you can call it disadvantages. First is limited capital. See, your capital is brought by all the partners, but still large scale production, large scale लाइक कंपनी टाइप, दे कैन नॉट हैव दैट कैपिटल. ओके, कंपनी टाइप में क्या होता है जो हम नेक्स्ट में आगे पढ़ेंगे कि वो लोगों से शेयर इश्यू करके दे कैन हैव मच कैपिटल, बट यर लिमिटेड नंबर ऑफ पार्टनर्स आर देयर, सो लिमिटेड कैपिटल इज देयर, अनलिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी. ओके, लाइक सोल प्रोपरेटरशिप ऑल्सो योर पार्टनर्स हैव अनलिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी, मीन्स इफ एनी ड्यूज आर देयर दे हैव टू सोल देयर पर्सनल प्रॉपर्टीज, देयर पर्सनल हाउस, कार, एवरीथिंग एंड क्लियर द ड्यूज. So this is also one type of a limitation. Possibility of disagreement. Many a times it happens that all the partners do not agree. Okay, so the partnership may come to an end, or the partnership may come to an end. So many times there is a possibility of disagreement. Next is difficulty in maintenance of secrets. Like sole proprietorship, your secrets cannot be maintained. Why? Because everything has to be discussed among the partners. First they have to discuss, and then only they can implement. So the as secrecy is maintained in sole proprietorship, that much secrecy cannot be maintained. Difficulty in share transfer. If any of the partner wants to leave the partnership, he cannot easily transfer his share without the consent of other partners. Delay in decision making. Many a times when any of the partner does not agree or what, so because of that there may be any delay in decision making. Short life span. Okay, as I earlier told you, if death of any partner occurs or any partner become insolvent, the partnership may come to an end. So we can say the lifespan of such type of form of business is also short. Now students, here we complete our this lecture. Okay, today's your homework is to write about characteristics, advantages and disadvantages into a classwork and submit to a concerned teacher. Thank you, have a nice day.